Isang magandang umaga mga kapatid ko sa Panginoon. Ilang araw na lang at matatapos na ang year 2021. Kamusta po ang taong ito para sa iyo? Naramdaman ba natin ang katapatan ng ating Diyos? At naramdaman ba rin natin ang napakalaking pag-ibig ng Diyos sa bawat isa sa atin? Naniniwala ba kayo na walang pwersang mas makapangyarihan kaysa sa pag-ibig ng Diyos Ama para sa atin na kanyang mga anak? Ang kanyang pag-ibig ay can move mountains, stop the roaring seas, magpagaling ng mga sakit at sugatang puso, magbago ng buhay at palayain ang mga namumuhay sa kasalanan at kahihiyan. Napakalaki ng kanyang pag-ibig sa iyo at sa akin na ipinadala niya ang kanyang bugtong na anak upang mamatay at upang tayo ay mabuhay sa pamamagitan niya. And in John chapter 17 verse 25 to 26, ang ating Panginoong Jesucristo makes an unfathomable statement about how great the depth of God's love is for us. Ito po ang sinabi sa John chapter 17 verse 25 to 26. O righteous Father, the world has not known you, but I have known you, and these have known that you sent me, and I have declared to them your name, and will declare it, that the love which you have loved me may be in them and I in them. Tayo po'y saglit na manalangin. Aming Diyos Ama na sa langit, tunay nga, pinupuri ka namin at pinapasalamatan sa araw na ito. Nawa ang iyong pangalan ang aming maitaas at sa aming pag-aaralan kayo ang aming mag-glorify. Sa pangalan ng aming Diyos at tagapagligtas niya si Jesus. Amen. Do you know that God loves you the way God loves Jesus? His heart is full of affection for you. Jesus always prays perfectly in line with the will of the Father because they are one. So when Jesus prays for God to love us with the same love he has been given, his prayer is in perfect alignment with the heart of our Father. And in Romans chapter 8, verse 37 to 39 says, yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature or created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. From this passage alone, God loves you simply because He loves you. Please remember that. You don't have to work for His affection. Hindi mo kailangan itong pagtrabahuan, mga kapatid sa Panginoon. You don't have to set yourself straight before God can pour out His love over you. And one great example is the father and the prodigal son. The story, the father ran out to meet his son before anything had been set right. He didn't know his son was there to apologize. He didn't care. He simply wanted to love his child. This is the same. Our Heavenly Father feels the same way about you and about me. He longs to love you right where you are, as you are. He longs to fill you with love to overflowing. He longs for us to experience this love and oneness just as Jesus did when He walked the earth. Kaya nga mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, as you enter into a guided prayer, open up your heart and allow God's grace to settle in your heart Allow him to free you from work-based religion and guide you to a lifestyle of relationship with God. God is not angry, or God is not an angry taskmaster who shows affection only when you and me succeed. He is a loving Father who will always love you no matter what. Kaya nga po, take time to receive the depth of His love for you today. Allow His love to heal you, transform you, free you, and lead you to abundant love or life He has set always and long to give you. You can meditate on the depth of God's love for you in these two passages. And it says in 1 John chapter 4, verse 9 to 10, "And this is the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent His only Son into the world so that we might live through Him. In this is love, not that we love God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the propitiation for our sins." And also in 1 John chapter 4, verse 16, and we will close with this. "So we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him." Brothers and sisters in the Lord, God loves you so much. Let us pray. Our dear God, we thank you, Lord, for your word again, for this meditation. May you sink this in our hearts. Bless us, Lord, and all those who have heard your word. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Magandang umaga pong muli. Happy New Year, and may God bless you all.